สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome to Hot Thai Kitchen. Today I'm going to share with you 5 different ways you can use curry paste that is not making a curry. Because I don't need to tell you about that one, right? Now, a lot of people buy curry paste, but the only thing they ever make out of it is curries. But in Thailand, we use curry paste in so many different ways. So if you've got curry paste sitting in your cupboard and you want to try something new, this video is for you. And before we start, if you have questions about curry paste in general, I do have a curry paste 101 video where I talk about what is a curry paste, how to choose, how to store, and all that good stuff. I will link to that video right over here. Number one, meatballs, sausages, meatloaves, burgers, anything that uses ground meat. So recently I posted a video on Northern Thai sausages that's basically ground pork spiced with a curry paste. And you can apply that technique whenever you make anything with ground meat. Ooh, how about like a masaman curry meatloaf? That would be delicious. So I also have made fish cakes where fish is ground up with red curry paste. I've made green curry spring rolls where the filling is ground turkey and green curry paste. So lots of different options. And also, I will link to all the recipes that we talk about today in the description below. Number two is stir fries. Curry paste make the best stir fry base sauce, and it makes it incredibly easy because you've got most of your flavors that you need in that one paste. So simply just saute it, thin it out with a little stock or a little coconut milk to make a sauce. You can season it with fish sauce, soy sauce, a little sugar, and then throw in any vegetables, any meat that you want. You can make it a little wetter so you get more of a saucy stir fry, or you can make it drier so the curry paste really clings on to the vegetables, concentrated flavors. Lots of options there, and it's a really quick dinner idea. Eggs. Might be surprising, but curry paste and eggs go super well together. We make this dish called hom mok, where it's basically red curry paste, coconut milk, and eggs, and we steam it so it sets into the super soft custard. Ah, it's to die for. Now, you can also add the curry paste into like frittata or quiche, or in Thailand, some people make an omelet, a Thai omelet with a little curry paste in it. The options are endless. Number four is marinade. So I just put up a recipe for gai gole or coconut milk barbecue chicken where I make a simple curry sauce and I use that sauce as a marinade and as a glaze for that chicken. It's an incredible, incredible recipe. Make sure you check that out. But you can apply that technique using any kind of curry paste that you want and change up the meat. You can even try it with tofu. Use it as a marinade. It's just so full of flavor. Dips, sauces, and dressings. Think chicken satay or pork satay. Why does everybody love it so much? I can guarantee you it's not the grilled chicken or pork. It's the peanut sauce that they come with, right? And what do you think is at the very core of a Thai peanut sauce? It is curry paste. That's right. That's the flavor that makes everything else in that sauce shine. So you can apply that same idea to any other sauces that you're making. Salad dressing as well. We make a salad dressing that uses curry paste as the flavor base. I've even made dips that are not Thai dips. So I've made like a salmon dip with a cream cheese base, but I put a simple curry paste in there as well. Delicious. And as a final tip, so think of this as your bonus number six, if you ever want to make a Thai fusion something, curry paste is such an easy way to make that happen. One of my friends loves making Thai curry lasagna, where he uses a curry sauce as the lasagna sauce. I've made a Japanese okonomiyaki, where I flavor the batter with curry paste. And if you think about anything that's rich and creamy, like a mac and cheese or like a chicken pot pie, like those are all great candidates for being spiced up with curry paste. So those are some of my ideas. If you've got other ideas or if you've done something with curry paste that's really cool, really interesting, we would love to hear from you. Share them in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed to the show, make sure that you do so you don't miss an episode like this. And when you do, click that little bell icon so you get a notification when I post a new video. And if you love the show and you want to support us, you can check us out on Patreon. The link will be in the description box. And I will see you next time for your next delicious Thai meal.